Eldrad Ulthran is a long-standing character of the Craftworld Eldar. He's spent 10,000 years trying to find a way to avert the final collapse of the Eldar civilization, standing as the High Farseer of Ulthwé. And in Deathmask, he might just have found a way. Now in this video, we're going to show you how to paint him, just like you can see on the box packaging. And this miniature is beautifully detailed, so it's going to be a lot of fun to paint it. So, let's get started. I've undercoated Eldrad with Chaos Black Spray, and then I've actually already done one step because I've now painted the entire miniature with Abaddon Black, and you can see it here. It doesn't really look a whole lot different, but it is important this, because Abaddon Black and Chaos Black have a different finish to them. Now this is important because later on, if you make any mistakes and you have to neaten up with Abaddon Black, then you will notice this difference and it doesn't look very nice. So if you paint the whole model with Abaddon Black before you begin, you avoid this happening. Now, Eldrad has robes with four different colours on them, and this is going to be the first part we work on because it's the main part of the miniature. And these four colours are purple, yellow, cream and black. And I'm going to paint these in a particular order, which is a nice easy way of doing it, and I recommend you follow along with this sequence to make it a bit easier for yourself. The first colour we need to do is the purple parts, and the first paint for this is Naggaroth Knight. Now, as always, give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to apply this with a small base brush because these parts are quite small. Now, I recommend you use a palette throughout the process of painting this miniature because it gives you a lot of control. So you get some of the paint, put it on there, and this allows you to thin your paint with some water. You don't need very much, but doing so just helps the paint flow smoother, dry thinner, go a bit further as well. So you want your mix kind of like that, you don't need too much on your brush, and all you've got to do is start applying this to all the purple parts. Now in the case of Eldrad, what we're looking at here is his sash, so just around here, and also the part that goes down in front of him here, so like this loincloth-like bit we've got here. You don't have to worry about being neat at this early stage, because we will neaten up as we add more colours. With that base colour applied, the next thing to do is to add some shade to give the robes a bit of depth. So we're going to use Norn oil to do this, and we want to apply this in a very careful way, so I recommend using a small airbrush for it, and also, once again, to make use of your palette, just to make sure you don't have too much shade on your brush. So just use it to get rid of the excess there. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint this directly into any creases that you can find. So for example, on here, just into this recessed area, like that. Once the shade's dry, all we need to do is highlight the fabric to finish the purple parts off. And to do that, we need Jean Stealer Purple, still with a small airbrush for this, and you definitely need to use your palette for this colour because we need quite a lot of control here. So make sure you add a small amount of water into your mix there, and then, oh, a little bit more than that, I think, there we go. And then, just drag your brush and twist it along to bring the bristles to a nice tip, because what we're looking to do here is to paint some fine lines. And you're looking for all the sharpest creases on the fabric. So a great example of that is actually all the way around the edge, in which case you can use the side of your brush and just follow that along there, need like that to get a nice sharp line. But there's also that crease down the centre, and for this again, just hold your hands as steady as possible and follow that central line there like that. We've now finished the purple parts of the robe and we can move on to the next colours, which is going to be the cream, but also the yellow, which we can do kind of at the same time. And the reason that we're going to do these colours before the black is because, as you will see, some of these parts are quite tricky to get to, so it makes sense to get them out of the way now. Now the first colour that we need is Zandri Dust for this, and I'm going to be using my small base brush to apply this mostly, but you could have a medium base brush in hand if you want to, it's really up to you. Whatever the case, make sure you get your paint nice and thin so we get a nice smooth result once all this is done. So really thin it down with a bit of water, looking for about that sort of consistency there. Make sure you don't have too much on your brush before you apply it. And, well, this colour, we're looking to paint this on the inside of his outer cloak. So we're looking at this kind of area inside here. And you can see what I mean about how some parts are going to be very tricky to get to as I get further back underneath there. And this does go all the way up here, up to his shoulders as well. So be sure to get up to there. And you will need to apply two thin coats as well. With that Zandri dust built up to a nice smooth coat, the next thing to do is to start painting in all the yellow parts. So our base colour for this is going to be Avalan Sunset, which once again I'm going to be applying with my small base brush. And this colour is a little bit trickier than the ones we've done so far, because now we need to do a small amount of freehanding. So to do this, make sure your paint's flowing really smoothly. It really helps with the process doing this. And make sure you don't have much on your brush either. In fact, I want to thin it down a little bit more. So there we are, about that sort of consistency. Twist your brush to get a nice tip. And it's just a case of colouring these parts in, really. And, well, on the front, we're looking at these strips down either side of his cloak. So you look at this flat area here. You just need to be as neat as you can when you get to the edges there to get a nice straight line. Now, the freehanding I'm talking about is when this line goes up over the shoulders, around the back here, you will need to paint this line in yourself. So just keep it at the same thickness and just follow it all the way around there like that. If you're making mistakes, just use Abaddon Black to neaten up that line. But also, on the tabard on the front here, if you want to have the yellow down either side, once again, just keep your hand as steady as possible and just follow that yellow round there like that. And as you can see, you will need to apply two thin coats. But whether you do this line along here is entirely up to you. We've now base coated in the cream and yellow areas, and what we need to do now is, well, start brightening them up. And we're going to begin with the cream areas using a shabty bone, which I'm going to begin applying with a medium layer brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush, because as you'll find out, you will need it to get to smaller areas. And you really must make sure you thin this colour down, because you need it nice and smooth, because you want a really nice smooth application and finish to this. So you want to be on that sort of consistency there. Make sure you've not got too much on your brush at once, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to all the cream areas of the robe. But this time, be a little bit selective about where exactly you apply it, because while we want to cover these larger open areas, whenever you get a crease, such as we've got going around the back there towards the front of his black robes, you want to avoid that part, just keep it darker so you get a nice bit of depth. Now also on the front here, whenever you're getting close to that yellow, just leave a thin line of Xandri dust showing in between the two colours there to give a nice bit of definition between the cream and the yellow. And you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour as well. With that shabty bone applied, we're now ready to brighten up the yellow. So we're going to do a very similar process for this, but this time using Uriel Yellow. Now I'm going to be applying this definitely using my small airbrush for the entire thing. And the reason why we had to put down Avalan Sunset first of all is that this is quite a thin colour and it is quite transparent. So having Avalan down first of all just means we're going to get a much stronger, brighter finish with this. So make sure it's nice and smooth. And when you're ready, you just got to start applying it over all the parts that you previously painted with yellow. So here we go, just along here as smoothly as possible, and I am going to be applying two thin coats as well just to build it up to a nice strong finish. The yellow is now nice and bright, but it is a little bit flat. So what I'm going to do now is just give it a bit of depth by applying a small amount of shade and, well, relayering it. So we're going to start out with Seraphim Sepia for this, then we're going to apply a little bit more Uriel Yellow. But starting with Seraphim Sepia, I'm sticking to my small layer brush to apply this, and you really don't need very much of it. So make sure to use your palette to control exactly how much you have in your brush. And when you're ready, all you're looking to do is apply one thin coat of this across the entirety of the yellow area. Keep that coat thin, and remember, don't put on too much at once so that you don't lose control of it. Let the shade dry completely, and then apply one more thinned layer of Uriel Yellow. And this time, you just want to avoid some areas where the shade has settled. So for example, this lower corner we've got here, just leave some of that darker colour showing through down there. Also, you're looking for areas where any armour shows through. So for example, just here we've got some of the shoulder armour with a sharp line there. I'm just going to leave some of the shade showing beneath that just to give it a bit of depth. With that done, we're now ready to highlight both of these colours of fabric. And we're going to first of all highlight the cream colour of fabric using Screaming Skull, and then we'll move on to the yellow with Pallid Witch Flesh. And the technique for both of these is going to be the same. Starting with Screaming Skull, what you need is your small airbrush once again, and we're looking to paint some thin lines here. So for that reason, it's really important to use your palette and to make sure your paint's thinned nicely so it's flowing really smoothly. Make sure you don't have too much on there at once, just twist away that excess paint. And when you're ready, what you're looking for is any sharper creases. So, for example, with the cream colour, there's not really that many, but you're looking for things like this edge along here, just as neatly as you can, just follow it along with a thin line of this colour. And with that done, we're ready to highlight the yellow using Pallid Witch Flesh this time, but the same technique, once again, pick out all the sharpest edges of the fabric. And there we are, we've now finished the yellow and the cream fabric, and we can start painting the black fabric, and also later we're going to do the black armour. But before we start doing any of that, it's important that you neaten up all these black parts using a bad and black first of all, just in case you made any splodges or mistakes or anything like that. And once you've done that, for the fabric, we first of all will highlight it using Eschen Grey, then we'll do a very fine highlight with Storm Vermin Fur. But starting with Eschen Grey, what you need is once again your small layer brush, and this is just like highlighting the fabric we've been doing so far. Make use of your palette to thin your paint down so it's flowing nice and smoothly, and then just to check, you just make sure that you've got that fine tip in your brush by just dragging it along and twisting it, and there we go. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to pick out all those sharper creases on the fabric. So once again, in areas like this, just follow them along with a nice fine line, and also go around the edge on the hem of the robe as well. Once you've completed that highlight, add a second one of Storm Vermin Fur, and this time what you want to do is focus it just a bit more towards all the sharpest corners on the fabric. Once you finish applying that highlight, the black robes are complete, and now we can start painting the black armour. And like with the robes, doesn't need to be any mistakes that you may have made on the armour before you begin with a bad and black. And what we're going to do here is use some different highlights from the robes to give them a different feel. Now first of all, we're going to use Dark Reaper as an edge highlight for all of the armour, and then we'll do a finer highlight with Fenrisian Grey. After that, we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh, and this is actually going to be just for the sword, which you can highlight in the same way at the same time, and you'll see what I mean in a moment. Now starting out with Dark Reaper, what you need is your small layer brush, and what we're looking to do here is to, well, be picking out all those sharper edges. So like with the fabric, be sure to thin your paint down so it's flowing really smoothly, and make sure you get that good tip in your brush as well. You want about that sort of consistency there. And when you're ready, you're just looking for all these sharp corners. So if I begin on the crest up here, because the corners are so sharp, what you can do is hold your brush about 45 degrees and just follow that corner along there like that to get a nice, neat, straight line really easily. Like I said, at the same time, we want to be painting the sword blade. So again, just angle your brush to catch those edges and just work your way carefully all the way down. When you're painting that central ridge though of the sword, you just need to hold your hands as steady as possible to follow that down. Once you've finished that highlight, you're now ready for the second one, which is with Fenrisian Grey using an extra small artificer layer brush. And you're just looking to focus this on the very sharpest points. You don't need very much. In fact, don't go overboard on it, because if you do, it can become a little bit too stark. So you see, I'm just focusing just on that corner there. Now on the sword, it's exactly the same thing. Again, just go along the edge where it's sharpest and a small way down the center. That's the armour fully highlighted, and now we just need to finish off the sword blade with a small amount of pallid witch flesh just on the very tip of the blade. And there we are, that's the black complete, and with that we've actually finished all the larger areas of colour on the miniature. Now we just need to start painting more and more smaller details. And the first of these we're going to work on is painting the armour of the last runes. So this is the bone colour details all over his armour. And to do it, we're going to start out with a base coat of Zandri dust. Now, I'm going to be using my small layer brush right from the start here, because these details are small and they're quite intricate as well. So you must make sure you get your paint nice and thin on your palette so it's flowing really easily. And just remember, just to be careful as you're doing this, just really take your time with it. So once your paint is ready, all you've got to do is start picking these parts out. And like I said, they're scattered all over the miniature. So if you're not sure which bits to paint, then just check out the photos on the back of the box. But remember, you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour. Once you've base coated all those details, the next thing to do is use a small amount of shade just to give a little bit of definition to certain parts of it. And for this, you need Seraphim Sepia with a small layer brush once more. And you really don't need very much of this. So just get a small amount onto your palette, get rid of the excess paint. And the kind of things we're looking for are recesses, and there really aren't many, but a great example of them is just here we've got this leather just going across the front of the bone just there. And you just need to paint some of the shade into that recess there. Once that shade's dry, we're ready to start highlighting all the bone to finish it off. And there's going to be two stages to this. First of all, we'll layer it with the shabty bone to brighten it back up, and then we'll add a highlight of pallid witch flesh to finish it off. But starting with the shabty bone, what we need is a small airbrush once again, and this is really just to, well, make those colours brighter that we've done so far. So really make sure you thin your paint down, because you don't need very much of this. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is retrace the steps from earlier of painting this over the bone. But this time, avoid the recesses where the shade has settled the most. So for example, where the leather crosses over the bone just here, I'm going to leave some of that darker colour showing just there and paint just away from it there like that. And once you finish that, you're ready to complete the bone by adding a highlight of pallid witch flesh just following along all the top sharper edges. And with that, the armour of the last runes is complete, and now we can start painting the next detail, which is going to be all the leather strapping. Now, all of this is going to be done with a base coat of Mournfang Brown, first of all, and then we'll shade it with Agrax Earthshade before finishing off with a fine highlight of Scrag Brown. Now, starting out with Mournfang Brown, I'm definitely going to use my small layer brush because these details are so fine, and some of them are actually bits hanging from his staff. Now, you might find it easier to come back to those later on once we've done the gold, but whether you do or not is entirely up to you. Whatever the case, once your paint is ready, all you've got to do is start picking these parts out, and I'm going to begin on the belts just around here and these leather straps down here. Next, apply a coat of Agrax Earthshade all over the leather, and you must be careful not to put on too much at once here because you don't want to lose control of it, so I recommend sticking with your small layer brush. Once the shade's completely dry, all you need to do is add a highlight of Scrag Brown to complete the leather, just following along with all the edges of it, and once again, just be as neat as you can. And there we are, that's the leather finished, and now we can start the next detail, which is going to be the jade colour that you can see in the staff. And to do this, we first of all need to base coat using Stegadon Scale Green, then we'll shade over it with Norn Oil. After that, we're going to start highlighting, first of all with a layer of Sotek Green, then a highlight of Temple Gar Blue, and then a very, very fine highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh to complete it. But starting out with our base colour of Stegadon Scale Green, I'm going to go for my small base brush for this, and this is just to, well, base coat in this area. So make sure to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. And once you're ready, you just got to pick this out. And the area we're looking at is this face design that we've got up here at the top of the staff. But also be aware, there's one or two parts down the half of the staff that have this colour as well, so be sure to pick those bits out too. With the base colour done, you're now ready to shade over these areas with Norn Oil. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to add a layer of Sotek Green. And for this, you're looking to leave the background darker, so you're just painting the face and these lines that are coming from it, but also leave any recessed detail on the face itself. So things like the eyes and around the mouth, that kind of thing. Next, highlight these details using Temple Guard Blue, and what you're looking to do here is just to pick out all the sharper features. And then finish off this area with a fine highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh, and all you need for this is some little dots on the very sharpest corners. And there we go, that's the jade done. And now I can start the next colour, which is going to be the silver. And there's not that much silver on the miniature, but all of it's painted in the same way. I'm going to start out with a base coat of Lead Belcher, then we'll shade over this with Norn Oil before giving it a highlight of Stormhost Silver. So starting then with Lead Belcher, I'm going to start with my small base brush, but some of these details are quite intricate, so even go to a small layer brush if you find you need to. Whatever the case, just get your paint ready. And once you're ready to go, it's just a case of applying this colour to these parts. So I'm going to begin on the staff here, on the haft of it. So I'm just being as neat as I can whenever I'm getting close to those parts we've finished so far. And I will be applying two thin coats of this colour as well. Then apply a coat of Norn Oil all over the silver. And once the shade's dry, highlight the silver using Stormhost Silver. In the case of the staff haft we got here, what I'm going to do is just paint a line just rolling along this side of it, just along here. With all the silver done, we're now ready to start painting in all the gold details. And there's a lot of these scattered all over Eldrad. So if you're not sure which bits to do, then just check out the pictures of him that you get on the back of the box. But to do it, we're going to start out with a base coat of Retributor Armor. Then we'll shade over these parts with Agrax Earthshade. Once that shade's dry, we'll start highlighting, first of all, with Liberator Gold. Then we'll finish off with a small amount of Stormhost Silver. But starting out with Retributor Armor, I'm going straight for my small layer brush here because, well, these details are often very intricate, so you need a lot of control here. So really make use of your palette to get control of your paint. And when you're ready, it's just a case of picking out the parts that you want to be gold. And I'm going to start up here on the sword, just picking out this part here for the handguard. And as you can see, it's very intricate, so just be as neat as you can. And you will need to apply two thin coats as well. Once you finish base coating all that gold, and well, you can see there's an awful lot of it, the next thing to do is to shade it using Agrax Earthshade. Now, I'm using my small layer brush now because, as you can see, this detail is very intricate and you mustn't lose control of the shade as you're applying it. So be sure not to put on too much at once. Allow the shade to dry completely, and then it's time to highlight the gold using Liberator Gold. And for this, we're going to do an edge highlight, so you want to follow all the sharpest edges just to pick them out. And then finish off the gold with a fine highlight of Stormhost Silver, just focused on the very sharpest corners of these details. Now, whilst you're at it with this colour, also it's a good idea to do a layer of this over the gems. You're looking for the middle part here. This is just a setup for the next stage where we paint these details. And there we are, all the gold is done, and we've actually started painting in all the gems now, and we just need to finish those off. And to do this, I'm going to paint all the gems blue, and I need Soulstone Blue to do this. Now, to use this kind of paint, what you need is a small layer brush, and you just need to get a dollop of it on the end of your brush. You don't need a palette for this, because you want to apply it directly from the pot, and you want to put on a good lump at once, a little bit more of that, I think, for a gem the size I'm going to go for first of all. I don't want a little bit more than that. There we go, right, because I'm going to start applying this to the one on Eldrad's forehead. Now, what you do is apply this dollop of the paint towards the bottom left of the gem, so there like that, and then quick as you can, pull it upwards so that most of it settles on the top right there, so you get more silver showing through on the bottom left, and then you just leave it to dry. And there we are, all the gems are done, as easy as that. And now we can start painting the next detail, which, well, it won't have escaped your notice, but Eldrad does have some freehand detail on him. And, well, you don't have to do this if you don't want to, because we've not done any so far, and the model still looks great. But if you do want to do it, I'm just going to show you some things to think about now, as we paint some runes onto those yellow strips on the front of his robes. I'm going to be using a Baden Black to do this, and really the key to it is getting the paint to the right consistency, and also keeping a steady hand. Now, I definitely recommend using an extra small artificial layer brush to do this. And what you need to do is thin your paint a little bit more than normal. What you're looking to do is to create a kind of consistency like ink, really. So the sort of mix we're looking for is kind of like that. You see it's flowing really easily, and then just make sure you get that good tip on your brush by just twisting it and dragging it along. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start, well, copying designs that you can see on the artwork and on the box. I'm going to start down in this corner here, keep my hands as steady as possible. I'm going to begin by just doing an upside down triangle. So just a line there like that. Like that. You see, I'm always taking my time, just being as steady as possible. If you do make any mistakes, just switch back to the yellow to neaten back up again. And there we go, I'm happy with the runes, and now we've just got one more detail left to paint before we start painting the base, and that is Eldrad's eye lenses. And to do this, first of all, we're going to base coat them using Corn Red, then we'll start highlighting, first of all, with Trollslayer Orange, and then a very small amount of Uriel Yellow. But starting out with corn red, I'm going straight back to my extra small artificial layer brush here because the eyes are really, really small in Eldrad, so you need as much control as possible. So really use your palette to get that paint under control. And when you're ready, what you want to do is just keep your hands as steady as possible because we need to paint around that bone detail around his eyes. So just be really careful as you base coat this colour in. And then add a line of Troll Slayer orange along the bottom of each lens. And then finish off the lenses with a small dot of Uriel Yellow at the bottom corner of each one. And there we are, the eyes are complete, and all we've got left to do is to paint the wraith bone that he's standing on. And to do this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Zandri Dust, then we'll pick out the vines using Wire Flesh. After that, we'll shade over all of this with Agrax Earthshade, before finishing off with a light dry brush of Pallid Witch Flesh to complete it. But starting out with Zandri Dust, I'm going back to my medium base brush for this, but have a small base brush on hand for when you're painting, well, around his robes and his feet and that kind of thing. You need much more control there. But for the other areas, because they're quite open, a larger brush like this is perfect. And all you need to do once your paint is ready is start applying this to the wraith bone, and you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour as well. Then pick out all the vines with Wire Flesh. Then give all these base details a coat of Agrax Earthshade. Once the shade is dry, all you need to do is lightly dry brush all this detail with Pallid Witch Flesh. And then after that, well, all you need to do is put some detail in the open areas of the base to match how you base the rest of your army. But with that done, your miniature is complete. I finished painting the base, and with that, Eldrad Ulthran is complete and ready to lead his people in their struggle against chaos. So the important things to remember about painting this miniature are that, first of all, you should paint the whole thing with a Baden Black, and that might seem weird when you've already undercoated it with Chaos Black spray, but you'll be glad you did later on if you make any mistakes, because a Baden Black and Chaos Black have a different finish. Paint the whole model with a Baden Black, you won't notice any difference when you come to neatening the model up. Now on the robes, there was a very particular way that I did them, but the really important thing was that I did the lighter colour before I did the darker colour, so the cream on the inside of the outer cloak. It's much easier to paint that part before you do the darker robes than it is the other way around, so I recommend you do the same. And finally, when you're doing the gems with Soulstone Blue, remember to apply it as a blob in the bottom left of each gem and then quickly pull it up to the top right so that most of the paint settles there. That way, you'll get a really nice result. And there you go. Now, we really hope that you have fun painting Eldrad Ulthran, and we'll see you again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?